I wanna tell you a story. The title of the story is Culture Also Needs Proof. On a sunny Sunday morning, Lala was having breakfast cereal with her sister Lolly. Lolly finished breakfast first. After breakfast, Lolly went to watch news about culture on the TV. She took the remote and turned on the TV. After a while, Lala finished breakfast too. Then she looked her sister, watched news on the TV, and she came to her. "What news are you watching?" asked Lala to her sister Lolly.
"I am watching news about the beautiful culture in Indonesia."
"So awesome," answered Lolly.
"Look, that is one of the dances from East Kalimantan, namely the Dayak dance."
Lolly is very happy to watch news about culture in Indonesia. And Lala, she just keeps quiet because she is not really interested for watching news about culture in Indonesia. She thinks there are still many people who protect and preserve culture in Indonesia. A few days later, Lolly looks happy. She wants to tell Lala about something that makes her happy. She comes to Lala, who is busy playing on her phone.
"Lala, I'm so happy."
"What? Happy for what?"
"I invite my friends to work together to build an organization to invite the nation's children to protect and preserve culture in Indonesia, especially in the modern era. And my friends act a bit. Oh, I'm so happy."
"Wow.
What?
Just wow. You don't hear me."
"I hear.
So, do you want to join?"
Lolly is annoyed because Lala is still busy playing on her phone. She doesn't answer Lolly's question.
"Okay, I wanna go. Bye."
"Bye. See you."
Lala is still busy playing on her phone. She doesn't pay attention to her sister who is talking. And one day, Lala is playing on her phone. She is playing Instagram. When she was busy playing, she found news about a culture in Indonesia claimed by a foreign country. This time, she was very serious reading the news. She looked sad and angry. Then she comes to her sister with a hurry.
"You must look at this."
"What?" Lala shows the news to her sister Lolly. Apparently, Lolly knows about the news. She is sad and angry too. But she looks Lala. Lala was very serious reading the news. She looks sad too.
"By the way, this is the first time I see you so serious reading the news.
Yesterday, you didn't want to know about culture in Indonesia," Jack Lolly.
"Right. I just don't act up and I'm not happy. This is Indonesian culture. Why other countries want to take that culture from us? I'm angry."
Lolly smiles and feels happy because Lala wants to care about Indonesian culture. "See?
I don't want a local culture in our country recognized by other countries. And from now, I want to be a cultural activist. I want to get to know and preserve our culture. If not us, who else? Like You say too.
Lolly is very happy to hear Lala, who wants to preserve culture in Indonesia.
I'm sorry, because yesterday I didn't listen to you when you were talking, and I also don't want to know about Indonesian culture. I'm so sorry.
It's okay, Lala. I feel happy because you want to care about Indonesian culture. Lala realizes her indifference. Then she asks to her sister Lolly. Does she want to join her sister organization? And Lolly said yes. Lala, her sister Lolly, and Lolly's friend start their organization, and they also use gadgets to reintroduce and invite millennials to protect and preserve local culture in Indonesia. Lala is very happy to join her sister's organization. And she is proud to live in a country with a beautiful culture. The end. We are the children of the nation's generation who will preserve culture in Indonesia. Protect and preserve our culture. Don't say you love Indonesia if your daily life never reflects that love. Remember, keep before living, take care before dying. Thank you.